The Lagos State Government has been dragged before a federal high court in Lagos for disbandment of the Judicial Panel of Inquiry and restitution for victims of SARS-related abuses in Lagos State and Lekki Tollgate incident. The plaintiffs in the case, Adekwile Augustine and Simeon Akogu, prayed the court to disband the panel on the grounds that the Lagos State Governor, being a party in the matter, did not exercise its power in public interest by setting up the panel. The plaintiffs are praying the court to make a declaration that the Lagos State Governor, being a party, cannot set up a panel to investigate itself, and the outcome of the panel will be in favor of the state. The plaintiffs averred that he who pays the piper calls the tune. Apart from the Judicial Panel of Inquiry, other defendants in the suit are the Governor of Lagos State, the Chairman of the panel, and the Attorney General of the state, who are first, third, and fourth defendants, respectively. The Chairman of the panel is listed as the second respondent in the case dated November 11, 2020, and filed at a Lagos Federal High Court. The plaintiffs, Augustine and Akogu, in the suit filed through their counsel, Samuel Adama, seek a declaration that the appointment of the second defendant and the setting up of the panel by the Lagos State Government is tantamount to making the first defendant a judge in his own cause and ipso facto breaches the plaintiff's right to fair hearing, that the first defendant constituted the third defendant and appointed all the members thereof at his pleasure, that since the first defendant authorized the military invasion that led to the various degrees of bodily harm and alleged death of many Nigerians who were at the scene at Lekki Tollgate on the 20th October 2020, he is a principal figure to be investigated, and hence it will not have fair hearing on the platform of the third defendant, which is a creation of the first defendant that is equally on the threshold of investigation over the matter. Basil Okafor, Court TV News, Abuja.